Hello everyone. So we are going to start our class, and the topic of today is polynomial. This is a very important topic in both the classes, class 9th and class 10th. We have this topic, polynomial. So what is polynomial? Poly means multiple. So multiple algebraic terms. Multiple algebraic terms means expression which have more than two terms is called a polynomial. So its general form we can write like this: a x n plus b x n minus 1 plus c x n minus 2 and so on. Here the first condition, a should not equals to 0, and whereas n is belongs to natural numbers, n belongs to natural numbers. So let's take an example: a x square plus b x plus c. This is a polynomial where a, b and c, these are the coefficients. Multiple of variables are coefficients. We can take many types of example like 2x plus 3, 2x square plus 4x plus 1. So these are the simple examples of polynomial. As you know, in class 9th we already studied about degree. So what is degree? Degree of polynomial. So degree means any polynomial which have highest exponent, means highest degree, you can say highest power of polynomial is called degree of polynomial. For example, highest power. For example, 2x cube plus 3x square plus 2x plus 1. That is polynomial of variable x is equal to this one. So what is the degree of this polynomial? What is the degree? Degree will be 3. Highest 3. It's 2, it's 1, it's 0. So what is the highest degree, highest power? That is 3. So you can say degree is 3. So simple, to find the degree of polynomial, just see the highest power of polynomial, that will be degree of polynomial. Now we can identify the polynomial by the help of its degree. Let's see here. Degree polynomial, and you can take example also. So if the degree is 1, if the degree is 1, so polynomial is known as linear. Polynomial is known as linear. Example 2x plus 3, that is linear polynomial. And if the degree is 2, it is known as quadratic. Quadratic polynomial, or example of quadratic polynomial is 3x square plus 4x plus 1. And if the degree is 3, it is known as cubic polynomial. Cubic means degree 3, cubic polynomial. So 4x cube plus 3x square plus 2x plus 3, that is cubic polynomial. So degree defines the type of polynomial. If the degree is 1, it is linear. If degree is 2, it's quadratic. If degree is 3, it's cubic. Now let's see, let's find the value of polynomial. Value of polynomial. How to find the value of polynomial? So if any polynomial is variable, that is polynomial of variable x, 2x
plus 3.
So we can find the value of polynomial is any on any point, like on point 1, point 2, point 3.
So when you find the value of polynomial on 1, so what will be the replace the variable by that value? So 2, 1 plus 3. So what is the value? It's 5. Means on 1 the value of polynomial is 5. Let's see if let's find other value. 2 on 2. So 2, 2 plus 3. So 2 to the 4 plus 3 is 7. So on 2 it is 7. So like this you can find the value of polynomial. Now let's see how to find zeros. Zeros of polynomial. So what do you mean by zeros? Zeros are the simple things. When we put the value of x and we get the value of polynomial equal to 0, the value of x will known as zeros of polynomial. So simple. So you can say k is 0 of polynomial if px equals to if pk equal to 0. So value of k, and k is any real number, k may be any real number. So let's understand this by an example. So let's find any polynomial as 2x plus 5. So how to find zeros of this polynomial? So simple, 2x plus 5 put equal to 0 and find the value of x. It's minus 5 upon 2. So for this polynomial, minus 5 upon 2 is a 0. So the simple thing, if it is linear polynomial, it has 1 0. If it is cubic, it's 3. If it is quadratic, it's 2. So what it mean, how we can understand it by geometrically? Geometrically means if any polynomial px, if any polynomial px, it may be linear, quadratic or cubic. So every polynomial can be represented on graph. So if we have graph already, if a graph is given already and we have to identify number of zeros, how we can find? So if it is given variable x, means we will deal with x axis, that is a plane. So if the polynomial of variable x, we will deal with x axis. So graph may be in any form, like if it is linear polynomial, it will be a straight line. If it is quadratic polynomial, it will be like a parabola. So how to find zeros or number of zeros? So let's just see how many times the polynomial graph intersect x axis if the polynomial is in x variable. For example, that is any graph of polynomial px. So is this intersect the x axis? No, it is not intersected by x axis. So in this condition there is no zeros. And now see the other graph, x dash y dash, like this is a straight line of any polynomial px.
So how many times it intersect the x-axis? You can clearly see it intersect only one time here. So it means it has 1, 0, only 1, 0. Let's see one more example. Like this, you can see it is the graph of px means variable x. So let's just see how many times it intersect x axis. So it intersect x axis by 2 times. One is here and one is here. So we can say that simple, it has 2 zeros. Let's see one more example. In this polynomial px, this graph intersect 1, 2, 3 times. So it has 3 zeros. So simple it is. Means by graph we can identify number of zeros and their values also. Now see your exercise 2.1 in NCERT book. See here, graphs are given 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 questions are given. The question is, the graph of y, px. Px means that is polynomial of x variable are given in figure 2.10 below. For some polynomial px, find the number of zeros px in each case. Means, in each case, we have to find the number of zeros. In the question number 1, as you know, that is polynomial of variable x. So we have to see how many times it intersect x axis. In the question number 1, it never intersect x axis. So simple, you can see it has no zeros. Means number of zeros are 0. No zeros. In same question number 2, it intersect only one time here. It intersect only one time here. So simple, we can say it has only 1, 0. In same question number 3, it intersect 1, 2, 3 times, means it has 3 zeros. So like this, you can do exercise 2.1 in of your NCERT book. So it's very simple exercise. You can solve yourself. So solve this exercise by yourself. If you have any query, you can ask to me anytime. So I hope you enjoy the class. Thank you.